Welcome back to Andrew Penman YouTube. Thanks for joining me. You're with your host, Andrew Penman. Thank you so much. I'm going to be doing the unbox today of the Cloudwheels 120Hs. Now, if you're new to my channel, consider subscribing. I've been doing this longer than anyone. I do electric skateboard reviews. I do gadgets, modifications, hacks. I do the skateboard carving street boards like the carvers and the surf skates, but more importantly, the smooth stars, where I'm an ambassador. Big shout out to Rhett and the team and Paul. That is an amazing board. But look, we're digressing. Today, we want to talk a bit about what is coming out for Cloudwheels. Now, Yuri, thank you so much. Yuri sent me these wheels to review. You might have seen my first impressions of the donuts on the WowGo night. This one here, the 105s. Check out my reaction. And I said something like...
Just effortless. I mean...
Yeah, that's right. It's the same blindfold as a 6-inch pneumatic tire. Well, it is. It technically is. It's incredible. What this actually does is give you the feel of you've got an air tire or a belt drive. It's that good. You know, it really is incredible. So I'm expecting big things today from the 120s because the 105s are a lot smaller. But the thickness of the urethane and the whole setup is the same thickness, it's just a bigger diameter, which will give you more circumference and I think again a little bit more rebound. So what am I doing it on? I'm doing it on the TeamGee H20. Now, I love this board. I just love the styling of this board. I love the vibe, the energy, the undercarriage like a Batmobile. I'll put the gel wheels on these, the orange ones. You saw that in the video in the corner here. I'm reluctant to put something on this because I just love that look, but I don't like the get it across the footpaths and guttering with these little tiny half-inch urethane damper. It just doesn't work. These are designed for smooth roads, for smooth parks, for somewhere where you need to have a nice smooth area. But when you go onto anything that's not smooth, they do suffer. So when I was in the city, I used to take my belt drives, my pneumatic tires for the tram tracks and the paving. I took this WowGo in last week and it was just like riding a belt drive. It was just like riding, this is the 105s, right? Like just so smooth like butter, and there's no need to have a belt drive anymore. We don't need to have that incredible, you know, protection of rebound and soft ride. That will do it on a donut. So let's open what we got today, which is, thank you to Yuri. Yuri has done an incredible job of designing this wheel. Here we go, they're the 120s and they're orange. I've got another box of 20s orange there, which I'll be putting on my other board. But for all intents and purposes today, we'll just use the one and put it onto this. And I'll do a quick little 2 minutes and show you how they go on. There's no screws, there's no nuts because they just slide on with the slots. They're designed to fit on the H20 and the H20 Mini. If you've got the Mini like mine, the early one, the not 90 millimeter wheels, they won't work on that Mini. But if you've got the 90 millimeter motors, they will work. But bear in mind, it's a fish deck. There's no cutout and it's going to be really, really, really tight for your wheel bite. So you have to pack them out with the spacers and risers that they give you and probably buy extra gel pig ones to really build it up. So it'll sit high, but it will work. It won't get wheel bite on the Mini, but I'm going to use it on the H20 longboard. It'll look good, it'll feel good, and it'll give a really nice ride. You know what? This will go on so easy. They just slip on, the cap goes back on, done, dusted, finished. It is just such a good look. Now, there'll be no wheel bite on this. I'm predicting that's going to be pretty much, there might be a little bit, but we can. We'll obviously have to put the spacers and the risers in. So today we're going to take it for a test ride. We're going to see what we think about it and how it works. If it doesn't work, if it does work, it's really going to be a beautiful feel. And I think it's going to really enhance the overall versatility of this board because it will then be able to be used on many circumstances. These boards are virtually waterproof. But hub mode, you can go through puddles and rain. You can go for a bit of sprinkle because they're all sealed. They're all sealed unit. Technically, they go underwater nearly. But, you know, the problem is with the belt drives, you get stuff in them and the belts get worn and then they get, you know, damaged as well as the motors are open. So you can't really do much with the belt drives. But with these beautiful hubs, they are becoming, again, more popular. You can see, you know, Meepo bringing out hubs. There's a lot of things happening right now in the hub place, like the transite board. So don't write a hub off, because until you've ridden one, it's a silent propulsion. It's just an amazing feel and I'm loving it. So this is going to be another dimension with these donut wheels and these clouds going on hubs, it's going to change the whole dynamics of how a hub feels. It's going to really change everything. So let's get out there and have a ride and have a talk about how it feels. And we'll just flick you now to a quick video of me whacking them on, and we'll show you how that works, and we'll head out in the field. I can't emphasize enough how well they ride and how good they feel. And if you've got a fetish for, you know, talk boards, 110 millimeter blue boys or the 107 Apex, believe me, nothing, and I can tell you, nothing to me feels as good as a cloud wheel like this or 120 on the road. It really does grip. It's got that lovely camber, so you can slide it a bit. It just moves a little bit. You've also got that grip where it really, if you hit it hard, you then flatten out that level on the road and you get a really nice grip. These flex like crazy under a slow motion camera. They work so well. I just love them. They are, look, for a Chinese guy to invent this for the skate industry is quite extraordinary. So this is actually quite an amazing invention, and it really has changed a lot of people's lives in terms of performance riding and just soft riding. It's just incredible. Guys, I hope you liked today's video. That's the Unbox on the clouds. Thank you so much, Yuri. We'll get these linked in below so you can see where to go, but just go to Cloudwheels. There's no links there. There's no discounts, unfortunately, but they're pretty affordable and they're quite cheap. The Cloudwheel, there they are, the 120D Discoveries with the 120H Donuts. I can thoroughly recommend them based on my original review of the 105s. Let's get out and test them. Quick little shot of how you put them on, and then we'll get on the road and I'll see you guys.
Here we are with the TeamGee, as you can see, H20. We're going to talk a little bit about the wheels as they are now and how they look. This spot. As you can see, that was pretty noisy and pretty bumpy. Let's put the clouds on, see how it goes, and we'll see what the difference is. I'll do a quick sound check now on these wheels with a sound meter.
Okay, now I'll just tell you how you work out how many rises you want. Basically, that's the new wheel, that's the new cloud. We'll put the old wheel, well, actually, we'll use the whole wheels, it's easy to see. There we go. If you look at that, you can see that one is not quite. You can see it's still here, the edge. So two spaces will give you the exact clearance you had before, just a fraction less, two spaces. So if you're like me, you carve really hard, you could actually put three risers on it. It'll sit a lot higher, but it will definitely carve like crazy. Okay, unfortunately, to get these new screws on, you're gonna have to either perforate the top of the grip tape, which will spoil this incredible grip tape, or you do what I do and you just get a razor blade and you just gently take it back. Be very careful, and what you're doing, you're using the razor blade to take away the contact surface of the glue. Don't pull or stretch the grip tape because you'll actually damage it. When you get to a certain point, you can actually then just use the leverage of the tape. Okay, on second thoughts, I'm going to go three risers because it actually gives you a lot more clearance.
Okay,
all right. So once you've got that on, the clearance now is huge, and you'll put the grip tape back on. I've mounted my shred lights, as you can see just there. You can see they're just under the very bottom, the last riser. And make sure your fingers and hands are spotlessly clean when you do this, because you'll get axle grease or silicone grease over your stripes. That's it. You can't get that up. Wow. Let's take a good look at it now. Okay, now the moment of truth. Let's see how accurate the engineering is from Cloud Wheels. Okay, ready? Let's go. One, two. Oh my gosh. Don't have to even hold the camera. It's that. It's not even 1 millimeter out. Not even a half. A third of a millimeter. Incredible design engineering. Beautiful stuff. Bye.
think to myself, what a wonderful world. What a wonderful world.
So we made it back. We've got the wheels on now. There they are. That's the Donuts, the H20s. We'll test that now and see the difference on this corrugated concrete angle. That's the thing. When I said it was bumpy, this is super smooth. However, this angle carving on is corrugated concrete. So it's got big expansion joints. So we'll see how quiet it is. We'll do a meter test on it and see if there's a difference. So let's get into it. Jeez, for a first attempt, dead quiet. Incredible improvement.
You know the galaxies of my heart.
So straight away, the improvement is literally 80% quieter and you can't feel those corrugations at all. So, you know, this has just been mind-blowing. I've never experienced a transition from a hub motor to that feeling of like a belt drive. You literally have no feeling of a hub motor in here. Brilliant. So I'm also very impressed with the grip. So on the original urethanes on these TeamGee H20s, they're a little bit slidey on the smooth concrete here. Even though it's got stravings on it, the corrugations, it still is a bit slidey. This, no way it moves at all. If you look at the edge of that chamfer, what happens as you come into on that edge, the wheel, let me try to get it there. As you come in, the wheel, it sits on that angle. So it actually has more surface area because of the tapered camber of the wheel. So it actually affects that greatly where you've got the full wheel on the actual slope. You know what I mean? Let's go a couple more runs. Made it this far into the video, dude. Congratulations. We're at the Manly Quarantine Center. We got some amazing location, 1890s haunted settlement here. We're gonna do some great footage and some great music. So let's get into it and we'll do the cloud donut. As you can see, we've just had a pit stop here and we're now going to take off again and have a ride around here and get some nice footage. So thanks for stopping in this gorgeous place, the Quarantine Center here in Sydney. It is absolutely incredible and these are normally rented out, but of course COVID, nothing's happening right now, so yeah, pretty much non-existent. See, you can actually ride them on this massive gravel. Guys, thank you so much for staying around to the end. This has been an epic unbox and first ride of these new Cloud Donuts 120Hs. Thank you so much, Yuri. The rating for today is going to be 9.8 out of 10 for these, because they are actually turn this hub drive motor into a belt drive feel. It's so smooth and so forgiving. So yeah, I can't possibly comment any highly about that. They are really beautiful. So guys, that'll be it for today. I'll see you. Lots of stuff happening. We've got some carving boards coming, the new smooth star training, as well as some updates on the other board. So look, stick around. We look forward to seeing the next video. Till then, happy skating, safe skating, keep carving. See you in the next video. So we are here quarantining within quarantine, in a quarantine station. This is it here, look at this. This is the actual original dining room. And you can see it in here. It hasn't changed much at all, except there's no one being quarantined. Well, I forgot to do the disclaimer. I'll do it now. We rolling? Action, thank you. Hey guys, there's a small disclaimer on these wheels I've got to let you know about before you use them. So I'll make it pretty short and sweet. Here we go, ready? 1, 2, 3. Don't try and bank yourself. Make sure you're buying from the registered dealer. Make sure you're buying the Cloudwheel only. Make sure if you're doing the Facebook page, the Facebook page, or the Cloudwheel Facebook page. If you're going to install them, make sure to install them in accordance with my instructions. My instructions video in the corner there. Make sure you follow them. Make sure you come back to 3, paragraph 4. None will apply, will apply, won't apply. Otherwise, it's void. Contract void. Don't cut them. Don't spray paint them. Don't grind them in half. Don't put them in the ground. Don't water them. They won't grow into anything. Don't give them to anyone under the age of 6. Don't put them on a pram. Don't do anything like that. Just don't smuggle them. Don't use them for quarantine purposes to get out or get into quarantine. And also, don't eat them. If you eat them, don't look at the box. Nothing on the box. It'll tell you what to do, but go to the medical center urgently. I think that was it. Guys, enjoy and have fun with your new Cloud Wheels.